Hello everyone, welcome back to Global Online University. In this video, I am going to share with you most important MCQ of banking and financial institution, which is really important from the exam part of view. So do watch it. Before starting with lecture, I want to tell you that Global Online University has come up with a commerce course in which you will get previous year question paper test from year 2015 to 2020 with the detailed explanation, plus 10 mock tests with the detailed explanation, full syllabus notes of all the 10 units, 200 plus video lecture. For the more information, you can contact on given number and you can also download our app Global Online University. This course will really help you to achieve your target. So do join it. In this question, list 1 and list 2 is given and you have to match the list 1 with the list 2. So in list 1, the name of the organization or a name of the bank are given, and in list 2, the year of establishment is a given. The list 1 is IDBI, ICICI, LIC of India and the SIDBI. To answer this question, you have to know about each organization when this organization got established. So first one is the IDBI. IDBI is the Industrial Development Bank of India. Was constituted under the Industrial Development Bank of India Act 1964 as a development financial institution and came into being as on the July 1, 1964. Then is the ICICI. ICICI formed was the 1955 May at the initiative of the World Bank. The government of India and the representative of Indian industry. The principal objective was to create a development financial institute for providing a medium term and a long term project financing to the Indian business. Then is the LIC of India. The Life Insurance Corporation of India established was the 1st September 1956 when the Parliament of India passed the Life Insurance of India Act and nationalized the insurance industry in India. And then is the SIDBI. SIDBI is a Small Industrial Development Bank of the India जो कि अफेक्ट्स रेगुलेशन रेगुलेटरी बॉडी है ऑफ ओवरऑल रेगुलेशन एंड लाइसेंसिंग ऑफ अ माइक्रो फाइनेंस इंस्टीट्यूशंस इन इंडिया. ये एस्टैब्लिश हुआ था 2 अप्रैल 1990 को थ्रू द एक्ट ऑफ द पार्लियामेंट. इसका जो हेडक्वार्टर है वो है लखनऊ में. द सिडबी ऑपरेट अंडर द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फाइनेंस गवर्नमेंट ऑफ द इंडिया. द करेक्ट आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन इज ऑप्शन नंबर सी. आईडीबीआई एस्टैब्लिश इन 1964, ICICI 1955, LIC of India 1956 and SIDBI 1990. SIDBI was set up as per the subsidiary of IDBI too, and options are take over the functions of small financing of IDBI, take over the venture capital operation of ICICI, reconstruct and rehabilitate the SIC and the close industrial unit financed by IDBI, facilitate finance and promote India's foreign trade. Now to answer this question, you have to know about the SIDBI. SIDBI is the Small Industrial Development Bank hai jo ki established hua tha 2 April 1990 ko by the government of India, and ye wholly owned subsidiary tha IDBI ka. It was dealing from the IDBI on 27 March 2000. SIDBI is the operating different program and a scheme through the 5 different regional offices and 33 branch offices. SIDBI was set up to take over the function of a small business functioning of the IDBI. It is a setup for managing a small, medium and a micro enterprise of the economy. So the answer for this question will be option number A, take over the function of a small business functioning of IDBI. The next question is, what is hawala? The options are tax evasion. Tax evasion is an illegal activity in which a person or an entity deliberately avoid paying a true tax liability. Those catch avoiding taxes are generally subject to the criminal charges and substantial penalties. Then is a illegal trading in the stock exchange. Insider trading is highly discouraged by the Security and Exchange Board of India, that is a SEBI, to promote a fair trading in the market for the benefit of the common investor. Then is a bank robbery, the someone who steals from the bank. And last one is an illegal transaction of the foreign exchange. Now, hawala is the informal method of transferring money without any physical money actually moving. It is described as a money transfer without the money movement. Hawala transactions are made illegal by the Foreign Exchange Management Act, that is a FEMA, and Prevention of a Money Laundering Act, that is a PMLA. So the answer for this question will be option number D, illegal transaction of the foreign exchange. In this question, list 1 and list 2 is given. List 1 is the name of the bank and list 2 is year of the establishment. So in list 1, IFCI, SIDBI, NABARD and EXIM. Now the IFCI is the Industrial Finance Corporation of the India, is developed finance institute under the jurisdiction of Ministry of Finance, Government of the India. ये established हुआ था 1948 को as a statutory corporation. Then is a SIDBI, the Small Industrial Development Bank of India. ये established हुआ था 2 April 1990 को through the Act of the Parliament. It is a headquarter in the Lucknow. The SIDBI operate under the Ministry of Finance, Government of the India. Then is a NABARD. NABARD established हुआ था on the recommendation of B. Shivaraman Committee on July 1982 to implement the National Bank for the Agriculture and the Rural Development Act 1981. And last one is the Exim Bank. Exim Bank established by the Government of the India under the Export Import Bank of India Act 1981. The correct answer for this question will be option number D. So IFCI 1948 ko established hua, SIDBI 1990 को, NABARD 1982 को एंड एक्सिम बैंक 1981 को. म्यूचुअल फंड की इन्वेस्टमेंट मैनेजमेंट एक्टिविटी कौन मैनेज करता है? एंड ऑप्शंस आर स्पॉन्सर्स, एएमसी, कस्टडियन एंड आरटीए. स्पॉन्सर्स कॉरपोरेट एंटिटी है जो कि सपोर्ट प्रोवाइड करती है विद इन द फाइनेंशियल सर्विस इंडस्ट्री. देन इज अ एएमसी. एएमसी रेगुलेटरी बॉडी है म्यूचुअल फंड की. इट ओवरसीज ऑल द एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव, मैनेजरियल एंड ऑपरेटिंग फंक्शन ऑफ द म्यूचुअल फंड. देन इज अ कस्टडियन. कस्टडियन सेबी रजिस्टर मार्केट इंटरमीडिएटरी है, प्राइमरीली रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर सेफ कीपिंग ऑफ द सिक्योरिटीज. देन इज द आरटीए. रजिस्टर और अ ट्रांसफर एजेंट आर द ट्रस्ट or institute that register and maintain the detailed record of the transaction of the investor for the convenience of the mutual fund houses. The correct answer for this question is option number B. The investment management activity of the mutual fund is managed by AMC, that is asset management company. Mutual fund scheme India mein pehle kisne introduce ki thi? And options are Government of India, Reserve Bank of India, Unit Trust of India and State Bank of India. Now you have to understand what is mutual fund first. So the mutual fund is a type of a financial vehicle made of a pool of money collect from many investors to invest in the securities like a stock, bond, money market instrument and other asset. The mutual fund ki jo first scheme hai wo launch hui thi in 1964 ko aur ye launch ki thi Unit Trust of India ne. So the correct answer for this question is option number C. The first mutual fund scheme in India was introduced by Unit Trust of India. Features of commercial papers are, and options are, it is an unsecured money market instrument issued in the form of a promissory note. The highly rated corporate borrower can raise the short term fund through this instrument. It is an additional instrument to the investing community and all of the above. To answer this question, you have to know about the commercial paper and its a future. So the commercial paper unsecured short-term debt tool hai jo ki issue karta hai company or the corporation usually for the finance and a inventory and temporary liability. The maturity in this paper do not last longer than the 270 days day. ये इंट्रोड्यूस हुआ था 27 मार्च 1980 को बाय द आरबीआई इन द इंडियन मनी मार्केट एंड इनिशियली रिकमेंडेड बाय द वागुल वर्किंग ग्रुप. इसके जो फीचर है वो है, इट्स अ शॉर्ट टर्म मनी मार्केट टूल इंक्लूडिंग अ प्रॉमिसरी नोट एंड अ सेट मैच्योरिटी. ये एक्ट करता है एज एन एविडेंस सर्टिफिकेट ऑफ अनसिक्योर डेट. इट इज अ सब्सक्राइब at a discount rate and can be issued in the interest bearing application. The issuer guarantee the buyer to pay the fixed amount in the future in term of a liquid cash and no assets. So the correct answer for this question will be option number D. दिए गए सभी future commercial paper में include होते हैं. The holder of which instrument are a member of a company and have a voting rights. Now the options are treasury bill, commercial paper, debenture and equity. Treasury bill money market instrument है, short term debt instrument है, जो कि issue करता है government of India and permanently issued in a three different phases, that is a 91 days, 182 days and 364 days. इसे zero coupon security भी कहा जाता है. Then is a commercial paper. कमर्शियल पेपर अनसिक्योर शॉर्ट टर्म डेट है जो कि इशू करता है कॉरपोरेशन. टिपिकली इशूड फॉर फाइनेंसिंग ऑफ अ पे रोल, अकाउंट पेएबल, इन्वेंटरी एंड मीटिंग अदर शॉर्ट टर्म लायबिलिटी. देन इज अ डिबेंचर. डिबेंचर कॉरपोरेशन एंड गवर्नमेंट फ्रीक्वेंटली इशू करता है टू रेज द कैपिटल और द फंड. देन इज अ इक्विटी. इक्विटी इज द अमाउंट ऑफ अ कैपिटल इन्वेस्टेड और ओन बाय द ओनर ऑफ द कंपनी. This account is also known as owner or a stockholder or a shareholder equity. A calculation of equity is a company total asset minus its total liability. The correct answer for this question is option number D, because equity holder ko hum owner of the company bhi kehte hai aur usko voting right bhi milta hai. ICICI कब सेटअप हुआ एंड ऑप्शंस आर 1955, 1964, 1989, 1935. इस क्वेश्चन का करेक्ट आंसर है ऑप्शन नंबर ए 1955. पिन इन बैंकिंग ट्रांजैक्शन इज नोन एज एंड ऑप्शन आर पोस्टल इंडेक्स नंबर, परमानेंट आइडेंटिफिकेशन नंबर, पर्सनल आइडेंटिफिकेशन नंबर and public interlocking number. Here the personal identification number or a PIN is a numerical code issued with the payment card that is required to be entered to complete the various financial transaction. The core purpose of a personal identification number or a PIN is to provide an additional layer of security to the electronic transaction process. So the answer for this question is option number C, personal identification number. The next question is, e-banking business is essentially regulated by the Information Technology Act 2000, under which the personal signature is replaced by, and options are encrypted signature, image signature, digital signature and online signature. Here the e-banking is a blanket term used to indicate the process through which the customer is allowed to carry out a personal or commercial banking transaction using the electronic or a telecommunication network. The option is encrypted signature. Encrypted signature can only be used to encrypt the document. It is a popularly used in the tender portal to help the company to encrypt the document and upload. Then is the image signature. Image signature is a something that can be capable of describing property of the image without knowing the entire picture. Then is a digital signature. Digital signature is a electronic signature. Then is a online signature. And a e-signature or a electronic signature is a legal way to get a consent or a approval on an electronic document or a form. So the correct answer for this question is option number A, encrypted signature. The next question is, what is the wholesale market for a short-term debt instrument? And options are capital market, forex market, money market, any of the above. The correct answer for this question is option number C. Money market is a wholesale market for a short-term debt instrument. The first life insurance company to function in India. And options are Unit India Insurance Company, Bombay Mutual Life Assurance Society, Agriculture Insurance Company of India, and Oriental Life Insurance Company. Now the United India Insurance Company is a leading Indian government-owned general insurance company. इसका जो हेडक्वार्टर है वो है चेन्नई इंडिया में. इट वॉज इनकॉर्पोरेटेड ऑन 18 फेब्रुवरी 1938 एंड नेशनलाइज इन 1972. देन इज द बॉम्बे म्यूचुअल लाइफ अश्योरेंस सोसाइटी. इन 1972 विद द जनरल इंश्योरेंस बिजनेस एक्ट वॉज अ पास्ड बाय द इंडियन पार्लियामेंट एंड कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंटली द जनरल इंश्योरेंस बिजनेस वॉज नेशनलाइज विद द इफेक्ट फ्रॉम 1 जनवरी 1973. देन इज एग्रीकल्चर इंश्योरेंस कंपनी ऑफ इंडिया लिमिटेड. ये गवर्नमेंट ओन इंश्योरेंस कंपनी है एंड डेवलप फाइनेंस इंस्टीट्यूशन अंडर द ओनरशिप ऑफ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ फाइनेंस एंड गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया. इसका जो हेडक्वार्टर है वो है न्यू दिल्ली इंडिया में और ये फॉर्म हुई थी 2002 में. एंड लास्ट ऑप्शन इज ओरिएंटल लाइफ इंश्योरेंस कंपनी. ये जनरल लाइफ इंश्योरेंस कंपनी है. इसका हेडक्वार्टर जो है वो है न्यू दिल्ली में और ये एस्टैब्लिश हुई थी इन ईयर 1947 में. सो द करेक्ट आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन इज ऑप्शन नंबर डी. द फर्स्ट लाइफ इंश्योरेंस कंपनी टू फंक्शन इन इंडिया इज ओरिएंटल लाइफ इंश्योरेंस कंपनी.